In this video, we'll have a look at how simple it is to carry out the additional tests available with the clarinet. To conduct the reflex decay test, the operator should simply press the dedicated button on the keyboard. The status of the probe and the progress of the tests are indicated at the top left of the screen. Lower down, the screen shows information about the ear side being tested, the set ear canal pressure, and the characteristics of the current stimulus. Four different graphs are available for each ear. Graphs are shown on the screen two by two, and the operator can navigate from one to the other using the right-hand control knob. Before starting the exam, enter the settings window and set the stimulus activation time to be 10 or 20 seconds. Then, introduce the probe into the patient's ear and start the exam by simply pressing the start button on the keyboard or on the control box. The display will show a new window while the pressurization starts. Here, the user can set the side, frequency, and intensity of the stimulus. When ready, simply touch the stimulus button to start the acquisition of the tympanograms. Once the exam has been completed, the test results will be shown just below the graph, including the activation and deactivation timings of the acoustic reflex. Let's jump now to another set of exams, Eustachian tube function tests for patients with intact and perforated eardrums are available on both Clarinet Basic and Plus. Access the ETF for intact eardrums by simply pressing the corresponding button on the clarinet keyboard. Function button 4 is then used to switch between ETF for intact eardrums and perforated eardrums. This test protocol is based on the automatic acquisition of three tympanograms under different patient conditions, and since the interface is very similar to that of the tympanometry test described in the previous video, we will skip a detailed description. After the completion of the first tympanometry test, the patient is asked to swallow several times, therefore forcing the opening of the Eustachian tube. Once the patient has complied with the instructions, simply press the continuous function button to start recording the second tympanogram. The same procedure will be repeated for the recording of the third tympanogram. Results of the examination are shown on the right of the window, where the ear canal volume and the peak pressure values of the three tympanogram acquisitions will be displayed. The user can select the pressure value to be set in the ear canal, choosing values between -600 decapascals and 400 decapascals. Here, you can also start the exam by pressing the start button on the keyboard or the relative buttons on the control box. Results are calculated automatically and displayed on the right-hand side of the window. The three pairs of numbers are the initial and final pressure values recorded during significant pressure variations. These pairs of values can therefore identify the pressures at which the Eustachian tube opens, indicated by the label O, and closes, indicated by the label C,